It's the NFL on EA Sports as we are in the inner harbor of Baltimore at M&T Bank Stadium. The two teams emerging from their respective tunnels a minute ago to the approval of this Baltimore crowd. They're all set as their Ravens will match up with Dak Prescott and the Dallas Cowboys. Greg Zuerlein now, he'll handle the honors to get us started. And off we go from M&T Bank Stadium. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Throwing is Jackson. And looking for Andrews, but this is intercepted. Picked off by Micah Parsons. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Cowboy defense has a touchdown. Zuerlein connects on the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Devin Duvernay now returning from the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. Jabril Cox there on the tackle. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Here's Jackson to throw. Eluding the pressure right. He finds Latavius Murray, and he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. To throw is Jackson, buying time to his left. But oh, he almost had his second pick of the game. Probably should have, and he's frustrated as it falls incomplete.
Well, nearly another interception there. That would have been 2 drives in a row with a pick. He's got to start taking care of the ball way better than what we're seeing.
Interestingly, that throw was probably worse than the one he threw the interception on last drive, but fell incomplete. Being chased out left. Oh, it's complete. A diving grab there by Brown. Here's Jackson. Here's a diving catch right side. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Jackson now rolling to his left. Now he's going to throw deep back over the middle. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
That was an interesting look there because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them, and I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete.
7th play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on 3rd down. They'll roll him out right. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Lamar Jackson, such a threat with those legs, able to improvise and get the first. Jackson going with a screen for Murray. A lot of effort there for just a 3-yard gain, and now 2nd down. They run from the shotgun with Murray. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to 3rd down.
And this is why aggressive defense coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
Now Jackson. Throw left side complete.
Don't let me man up the A rail. I don't know why.
Inside the 10 to the 9. Now Bell.
So stupid. I spent that entire drive trying to man up the A rail with the safety. Didn't let me. Just kept that play leads. Some reason double covers a play open, so I have to fix it.
Extra point away from tying the football game. Oh, and now they're gonna fake it, and this is caught out in the left flat, and he's in for two. The fake works, and they take the lead.
Someone really wanted to be in the lead here, because that's a heck of a gamble, isn't it? You're down one, you kick it, you got to tie a ball game. Instead, they fake it. And I keep coming back to this every time I see it. Remember, if you're faking an extra point now, the ball snapped at the 15-yard line.
Yeah, you're giving up 13 yards as opposed to just lining up at the two and saying you're going to go for two.
You're running a big play, lots of yardage for one extra point. That's a heck of a gamble, but it paid off in this case.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Play action to Elliott. Here's Prescott. He's going to find Gallup here complete. Only 3 yards on the catch. It's third down.
Oh, I see you nodding your head along with me, partner, because it's pretty obvious what they were trying to do there on the drag route. With his speed, they're hoping he can turn the corner and maybe take this to the house. But that was excellent work defensively to make sure once he caught it, he wasn't going anywhere.
It's Prescott, forced out to his left. Prescott able to get down there at the end on the slide, and he has the first as well. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a first down. Throwing, Prescott. Left side to Lamb. And to the 36-yard line, taken down there after getting 8 yards. Throwing again on second down, Prescott, and he'll go right back to Lamb. Back-to-back receptions for him, and it's another first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down. So now they'll come up on second and 10, once again from the 28. Throw again, Prescott. That is caught. It's Cooper for the Cowboy touchdown. Amari Cooper, 28 yards. And the Cowboys have retaken the lead. Zuerlein good with a PAT. And that makes this a 14-8 ball game. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. A good balance attack for that last touchdown drive they had. Now it's time to see if they can do that again.
It really becomes a tale of two play callers, doesn't it? The offensive guy, he's in sync. Everything is working pretty well for the defensive guy.
What's going on the defensive
side? That's a tough one because he's prepped all week as well, and he can't get a bead on exactly what they're doing right now. What he needs is one of his guys just to make a big play and disrupt things.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. It's a gain of 22 as we tick towards the two-minute warning. On first down, Murray. And he's got some space here. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Latavius Murray, 44 yards. And the Ravens can take the lead now if they hit the extra point. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. Jackson here, he's going to look to throw. And this will be caught as they convert here for two. So two successful two-point tries now for them.
And you know what it does? It gives you a boost, a huge one for your team because, hey, you're dominating them now. They can't stop you either scoring touchdowns or two-point conversions. But how about the defense? You don't know what to do at this stage. You can't stop them in any direction.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description there. Maybe we're sitting in a nice royal box watching this type of a game. But let's face it, right now, the way it's going back and forth, it's going to come down to who can get a stop.
A reminder coming up here at halftime, we'll ship you off to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman will have first half highlights and analysis from a back and forth first half that we've seen. He's got his receiver, Cooper. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. It's a gain of 34. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. Meanwhile, Prescott's throw there caught by Gallup. And give him 6 yards here as he stopped near the 35 at the 34. Looking to throw again on second down. Prescott, and he'll hit the slant route. That's caught by Cooper. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. So it's first and goal and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. Try to run it in with Elliott. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. Down and goal. Prescott, and this throw a bit late as he couldn't reach back for it.
Now we got third and goal coming up, and couldn't you imagine being in that huddle, partner? You know they're looking at each other saying, we can't come away with just 3 points after this drive.
Yeah, they've covered a lot of ground. They want more than that three. Prescott on third and goal. And this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. Two first-half touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys have once again taken the lead. Oh, he missed it. No good. So this remains a four-point game. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going as they take over here with 11 seconds remaining. Flush to his right, and that'll be incomplete with just 6 seconds left on the clock.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
To throw again on second down, Jackson steps away to his left. He's going deep for Brown. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Brown, and he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. Hit halftime. Two quarters down. Two still remain. We step aside. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Okay, coach, yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter in what's been a tight contest so far. The Cowboys will get the football first here, and they have the lead as well as we are underway in quarter three. On the return, Tony Pollard from his end zone. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And Charles, they've got the lead. Put your coaching hat on here now. What's the game plan for the second half?
I think getting the running game going a little bit more, because I thought in the first half they didn't get it moving the way that they would like. They had success throwing it, but I think these first couple of drives, they'll want to get those running backs going and give them more opportunities, and I will guarantee you that those guys were lobbying for them in the locker room at halftime.
Give him five on the carry there, and it'll be second down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. That'll be third down. On third down, Elliott. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Give him 10 there. Good enough for a Cowboy first down. Elliott. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. A give to Elliott. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. On second and one, Prescott, and this ball is caught by Lamb. Touchdown, Dallas. Three touchdown passes now for Dak Prescott. And the Cowboys take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Zerline connects on the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Now after the touchdown, it's Zerline. He'll kick it away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
A big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. Throw's going to be incomplete.
I know he was trying to get the completion downfield, but the way this game has gone, with a few of the runs he's made along the way, he should have kept the ball and taken it with his feet downfield. That's the big play that shreds the defense. Instead, he thought to himself, I'm a quarterback. I've got to throw it. He bailed out the defense with that incompletion.
On third down, Jackson. He finds his man, complete. It's Murray. And he gets it just shy of midfield, but that's not enough. He's short of the marker. That one good for only six, and it leaves him with a fourth down. Flushed out right. And Jackson's so tough to stop. He's got a first down, and he gives himself up there at the end. 4 yards there as they let him out of the pocket, and he got enough for the first. On first and 10, it's Jackson. And Jackson cannot get away, and he'll go down. Big DeMarcus Lawrence getting in there and bringing him to the ground. We've seen him escape similar situations earlier in the game and get away for pretty good yardage, and that time they get him down.
Yeah, they've had enough evidence that he can get away and run for good yardage, haven't they? That time it felt like, okay, enough of this. Let's play it the right way and get him on the ground before he does any damage.
Back now in Baltimore.
I'm canceling my spy or something.
With possession of the football, but trailing on the big board as we get set for the fourth. The Ravens on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This is going to be 3rd and 13.
Old player. I'm gonna cancel the spot there.
And they're indeed gonna go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Sliding out of the pocket. And Jackson gonna have the first down as he will get to the ground to avoid the contact. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. He's going to drop this one down for Murray. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. Now it's Jackson. Escaping. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And he goes down. A small bit of adversity here on what's been a strong drive as they come up 2nd and 12. Steps away. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Murray. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. Jackson. Over the middle, and there's a diving catch.
Oh, why are they switching?
They get the touchdown there, and it's back.
Formation doesn't change at all, and then all of a sudden, every player's meant to guard on the other side of the field.
Scratched and slashed their way to stay in this game, and by now we should all realize they're not going away. Now the pressure again swings to their defense because they're going to need to find some way to get the ball back.
And now the pressure gets there and he goes down. So he couldn't get rid of the football and that deficit stays right where it is. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They play fake to Elliott. Now Prescott. Open man, right side, it's Lamb. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. Prescott and Lamb hooking up for the Cowboy first. So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They've got a 1st and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off. Off the play fake, Prescott rolling to his right. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's 2nd down.
I like his thought process and his ability to move and get downfield. But what I didn't like was the final decision, to go out of bounds. They want to keep the clock moving. Instead, they give the defense an extra timeout.
Eluding the pressure right. And he'll go down inside the 45 before going out of bounds. 5 yards on the scramble, and that's enough to pick up the first. A first down carry by Elliott. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. So they come up on 2nd down, and they can get another run like we just saw. Would likely put an end to this thing. Again, it's Elliott. And he gets it down to the 32. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. They'll run on 1st down. It's Elliott. And he can only manage to get a couple. 2nd and 8 coming up. Now a 2nd timeout called for by the defense as the clock will stop with 55 seconds remaining in the football game. This, in all probability, another run here on second and eight. The give is to Elliott. Looking for a seam, but finding none. He'll get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout. As the clock shows 50 seconds to play here in quarter number four. On third down, it's Elliott, and they will rally and stop him short of the first down. They get him to the ground at the 26. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to fourth down. And here come the whistles and a timeout with 7 seconds left. That is inches from the upright. It's no good. Wide to the left, and this score will stay right where it is.
Well, this winds up an empty possession. Everything looked okay. He just never got the ball on target. And knowing him, he'll be disappointed with that effort.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. They have time here, partner, for just one final heave.
And I have to look at from the defense's perspective here. We know what they're going to do on offense. The Hail Mary, try and get guys down.
Oh, and for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted. Picked off at the 19. And the Cowboys are going to hang on. On the final play, they get the turnover to seal this football game. Well, we were on hand for a fun and entertaining game here. Coming down really to that last play, great job defensively to get the pick and seal it.
And we know that every play during a game matters. You're never sure which one's going to be one of the key ones. But at the end of the game, when you analyze it, 3, 4, 5 plays are going to be the ones you focus on. And that last play was one of them. The last shot, had to take it, and they came up with the interception and sealed their victory.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. From Baltimore, so long, everybody. Sounds